Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 4.2. In the section we will see null spaces, column spaces and linear transformations again. Null space and column space are actually special vector spaces, and linear transformation is defined generally for any vector space. You know, actually its definition for the vector space R to the n. So here we will see the general definition for any vector space for linear transformation. So null space of n by n matrix A, namely we need an n by n matrix A to define null space, and we call null space of this matrix, which is denoted by null A, as you can see, is the set of all solutions of the homogeneous system, homogeneous equation. You see the matrix notation Ax is equal to zero, namely the given matrix is the coefficient matrix of this homogeneous system, and we take all possible solutions of this system and we create a set, and we call this set null space of the matrix, the coefficient matrix of this homogeneous system. In set notation, null space of this matrix A is written in this form. It is the collection of all vectors x such that x is an element of R to the n, and it satisfies the homogeneous system. We have two conditions here, and the collection of all vectors satisfying them we'll call null space of the matrix A. You know, to define the multiplication written here, Ax is equal to zero vector, and A is n by n matrix, and to define this product, x should be n by one vector, namely we should have the common number n. You know, the condition of the multiplication to define the product of them, we should have n by one vector. Therefore x is an element of R to the n. N is the number of columns, the number of columns of the matrix A. For example, A is 2 by 3 matrix. As you can see, we have 3 columns and 2 rows. Here M is equal to 2 and N is equal to 3. And we define some vector U, which has the components 5, 3, minus 2. You see, we have 3 by 1 vector. The number of columns of the given matrix is equal to the number of rows of the vector U, namely the number of components. You see, the number of columns of the matrix A will be equal to the number of components of the vector U. So determine whether U belongs to the null space of the given matrix in the example. According to the definition here, x should satisfy the homogeneous system whose coefficient matrix is the given matrix in the example. Therefore, instead of x, we should write u. So can we define the product of them? Yes, you see the common number 3. Therefore, we can find by using the first row and the column of the second one, we obtain the first number. The result will be 2 by 1 by cancelling the common number, 2 by 1 vector. So, using the definition, we have 5 minus 9 plus 4, and the second entry will be found as by multiplying the corresponding entries of the second row and the column of the second one. So we have minus 25 plus 27 minus 2. So we have 0 for both, which means that we have the 0 vector. We have the 0 vector. Therefore, the vector u is satisfying the homogeneous system. And we can define the product of them, namely x is u is an element of R to the 3. Okay, therefore u is in the null space of the matrix A, because u is a solution of the homogeneous system. Okay, u is an element of this set called null space of the matrix A. Okay, so the null space of an n by n matrix A is a subspace of R to the n. You see, all elements of null space are also elements of the vector space R to the n. Therefore, null space of a matrix n by n is a subset of R to the n, a subset of R to the n. Therefore, we can talk about whether it is a subspace or not of Rn. Namely, we can understand whether it defines a special vector space, a subvector space under Rn, the null space. So, you know, from the previous section, we have three conditions to check that it is a subspace or not. The first condition says that the zero vector of the vector space R to the n should be also in the subset null space of the matrix A. So the condition of the null space says that all vectors in this set should satisfy the homogeneous system Ax is equal to 0. So can we say the zero vector satisfies this condition? Yes, because the zero vector is the trivial solution of the homogeneous equation. Therefore, zero vector is in the null space. Because when we write zero vector for x, so we obtain a times zero, which is equal to zero vector. Namely, we have this equation. The zero vector satisfies the homogeneous system always. So we say this solution is trivial solution, if you remember. Therefore, we have the first condition. The second condition, when we take two arbitrary vectors from the subset, the addition of these vectors will be also in the subset given, null space. So since u and v are in null space, they satisfy the homogeneous system. A times u is equal to 0 and a times v is equal to 0. And we should find this thing to say that the addition of them is in also null space. So we start from the left hand side of this equation. We don't know yet it is equal to the zero vector. Okay, if we obtain zero vector for this term, we say that u plus v is an element of the null space, which means that we have the second condition. So a times u plus v is written as from the property, if you remember, we can distribute the matrix A into the parentheses. So we write a times u plus a times v. This is the property of the product of two matrices, actually. And we know this is equal to zero because u is in the null space. Namely, it satisfies the homogeneous system. Therefore, this thing will be equal to zero. Similarly, V is in the null space, therefore it is also equal to 0. 0 plus 0 will be equal to 0 vector. So this is equivalent to the 0 vector. It is equal to exactly 0 vector, which means that U plus V satisfies the homogeneous system also. Homogeneous system, which is the condition of the null space written here. So we say that U plus V is in the null space of the matrix A. Therefore, we have the second condition of the definition. The last condition says that the scalar multiplication will be also in the null space when we take any arbitrary number R and any arbitrary vector U in null space, you see. So we should show that according to the condition of the null space, A times RU should be equal to zero. Namely, this thing should satisfy the condition of the null space, which means that it is a solution of the homogeneous system. It should be a solution of the homogeneous system. So how can we find this? So we will benefit from the given information. U is in the null space, so it means that it satisfies the homogeneous system. A times U is equal to the zero vector, and R is a real number, so A times RU can be written in this form. Namely, we can write the number R in front of the other terms in this multiplication, since it is a number and according to the property of the matrix multiplication, if you remember. And we have R times A times U. Namely, we change the places of the number and matrix. Therefore, we know that A times U is the zero vector from here, and R times zero vector is equal to the zero vector, which means that we have this equality, and we say that R times U is in the null space. So we have the third condition of the definition. So null space of the matrix A, which is M by N, is a subspace. It is a special vector space of R to the N, where A is M by N. So we understood that null space of the matrix A, which is M by N, is a vector space. Actually, it is a subspace of R to the N. Namely, the number of components of every vector in null space is equal to N, which is the number of columns of the given matrix. Okay, the number of columns of the given matrix. So we have an example here. Let bigger H be the set of all vectors in R to the 4 whose components A, B, C, D satisfy the equations. We have two equations. Then we have two equations with four unknowns. We have a system, actually, a system of linear equations. Show that H is a subspace of R to the 4. H is a subspace of R to the 4. So we have two ways to show that it is a subspace of R to the 4. First, we can check the conditions of the definition. We have three conditions for the subspace. Therefore, this is the first way for finding the given set H is a subspace or not. Or we can benefit from the definition of null space, because we know null space of a matrix is a subspace from the theorem written here, from the theorem star. If we prove that H is a null space of some matrix, So we can say H is a subspace directly without checking the conditions. This is the short way actually. So we know every vector in the set, given set H, has four components A, B, C, D, and they satisfy the equations written here. So if we find the matrix form of this system, actually we have two equations with four variables, okay, so the coefficient matrix will be for this system by writing the other terms on the right hand side to the left hand side. So the right hand side will be zero, number zero. So we will obtain a homogeneous system for the set, for the condition of the given set bigger H. So the matrix A will be, when we consider the coefficients of A, 1, minus 1. For B, we have minus 2, minus 1 from here. For C, we have 5, 1. For D, minus 1 and 0. We have 2 by 4 matrix, which means that we have 4 variables, A, B, B, C, and D, and D, and two equations, which is the number of rows, which is corresponding to the number of rows. So the set H becomes a homogeneous system actually. Ax is equal to zero because the set is the collection of all vectors satisfying the system, homogeneous system. The system of equations can be written in matrix notation like that. Okay, Ax is equal to zero. Ax is equal to zero. This is the collection of all vectors satisfying this homogeneous system. So this is actually the definition of the null space. H is equal to the null space of the matrix A, which is 2 by 4. 2 by 4. So H is directly a subspace of R to the 4 from the theorem, as you can see. Namely, we don't check the conditions from this theorem. Okay, theorem star, the null space is a subspace of R to the n. Here, n is equal to 4. N is equal to 4. And we understand that H is a subspace of R to the 4, since H is the null space of the matrix A because of the definition. Okay, shortly, we find H is a subspace of R to the 4. So we know that null space A is defined implicitly because there is no obvious relation between vectors in null space and entries in the matrix A. We don't have any explicit expression for defining a null space of the matrix A by using the entries for the matrix A and the condition of the null space. We don't use directly the entries of the matrix A. We don't have an explicit expression between them. Therefore, we say that null space of the matrix A is defined implicitly. There is no explicit relation between vectors in null space and entries in A. So find a spanning set for the null space of the matrix A, which is 3 by 5. We have 5 columns and 3 rows. Namely, we will find the null space of this matrix given in the example as a set spanned by some vector. We should find the vectors v1, v2, blah blah, vn. Ok, Okay, what are the vectors such that the null space will be equal to of this matrix? This set spanned by these vectors. So from the definition of null space, all vectors in this subspace satisfy the homogeneous system Ax is equal to 0. Ax is equal to 0. And x is an element of the null space, and x has 5 components since we have 5 columns for the given matrix. So we will have 5 components for every vector in the null space. And to get a spanning set for the null space, we need to find a general expression for the solution of this homogeneous system. So to get a general expression for the solution, so we will find the echelon form of the augmented matrix, echelon form. So this is the coefficient matrix, and the last column, you know, will be the vector on the right hand side of the homogeneous system, which is the zero vector, as you can see. And every column here is corresponding to the variables of the system, namely the components of the vector x, okay, x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5. And after some row operations, we will see the echelon form of this augmented matrix. We will have two pivot positions. You can find yourselves two pivot positions, and in the third row we don't have any pivot position, and the first column and the third column are pivot columns since we have pivot positions here. Therefore, x1 and x3 are basic variables. The others, x2, x4, and x5, are free variables. Which means that we will find x1 and x3 in terms of the free variables. Free variables mean that we can write any number for them, and x1 and x3 will be found in terms of x2, x4, and x5. They are depending on free variables. Since we have free variables for the system, we will have infinitely many solutions for this system. From the first row of this echelon form of the augmented matrix, we have this equation: x1 minus 2 x2 minus x4 3 x5 is equal to 0. From the second row, 1 times x3, 2 times x4 minus 2 times x5 is equal to 0. And for both, we obtain x1 and x3 in terms of the free variables. x1 is equal to plus 2x2 plus x4 minus 3x5, and x3 is equal to minus 2x4 plus 2x5. As you can see, basic variables are written in terms of the free variables. So the solution will be, we have 5 variables, x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5, which are also the components of the vector x. Instead of the basic variables, we write their relations in terms of the free variables. As you can see, 2x2 plus x4 minus 3x5, x2, x3 is equal to minus 2x4 plus 2x5, x4, x5. And since we have 3 free variables, this will be the linear combination of three vectors since we have three free variables. Separately, we will write x2, x4 and x5 in this form, and we use the coefficients of x2, x4 and x5. The coefficients of x2 are 2, 1, 0, 0, 0 for each component here, plus x4, 1, 0, minus 2, 1 and 0, okay, as you can see. And x5 has the components minus 3, 0, plus 2, 0 and 1. When we add them, we will obtain this thing. Therefore, we have the equality. This is true. And we can do this operation for all vectors x, which are the solutions of the homogeneous system written here. Also, these vectors are the elements of the null space. Okay, namely, any element in the null space, any vector in the null space can be written in this form. So if you write w1, w2 and w3, or v1, v2, v3, this is not important. Every vector in the null space is the linear combination of them. Because x2, x4 and x5 are any real numbers, we can write instead of them c1 w1 plus c2 w2 plus c3 w3. Therefore, null space of the given matrix in this example will be actually a set spanned by the vectors w1, w2 and w3. So we obtained the spanning set of the null space. For this example, we have three vectors for the spanning set, and null space of the matrix given in this example is actually a set spanned by three vectors, which are w1, w2 and w3, and they are given here. Okay. So now we see the second special vector space called column space of a matrix, which is similar to the null space actually. Here directly we use the columns of the matrix A. You know, null space is the collection of all vectors satisfying the homogeneous system. AX is equal to 0. Null space is defined as the collection of all vectors satisfying this homogeneous system, but the column space of a matrix M by N, written as column A, is the collection of all linear combinations of the columns of the matrix A. In other words, A has N columns, and column space is the set spanned by the columns of the matrix A. Unlike the null space of a matrix, the column space is defined explicitly by means of linear combinations. We can see clearly the structure of a vector for the column space. We know that it is the linear combination of the columns of the matrix A. Namely, we can see an explicit relation between the entries of the matrix A and the vectors in the column space. Therefore, it is defined explicitly, unlike the null space, because we don't see any explicit expression for the vectors of the null space. After some doing operations, we see the clear definition of the null space, as you can see in this example. At the beginning, we cannot see a relation for a vector for the column for the null space, but after the operation, some operations, you see we see it is the collection, it is the linear combination of some vectors written here. But here, for the column space, without doing any operation, any thing, we see clearly an expression for the vector in the column space. This is the linear combination of the columns of the matrix A, written as C1A1 plus C2A2 plus blah blah CnAn. CnAn. And the matrix A is m by n, namely we have m rows and n columns, and for each column, you know, we have m components, okay, m components, namely A1, the first column, for example, can be written as A11, A21, blah blah, AM1, AM1, which means that we have m components. M components. So we see that column space of the matrix A is a subset of R to the M, not M. Okay. This is different from the null space Rm, the number of rows, but null space is a subset of Rn, the number of columns, the number of rows, the number of columns. Okay. So find a matrix A such that the set W is equal to the column space of the matrix A, where the set W is the collection of all vectors such that the components are written as 6A minus B, A plus B minus 7 times A, where A and B are any real numbers. So easily you can see this is the a column space of a matrix A, because by using the coefficients of the variables A and B for every component for a vector in W, so we write A times 6 1 minus 7, B times minus 1 1 0. Okay, every vector is actually the linear combination of the vectors written here, W1 and W2. It is the linear combination, all vectors of the given set bigger V are the linear combinations W1 and W2. Therefore, we can say W is a set spanned by the vectors W1 and W2. Okay, A times W1 plus B times W2. B times W2. So we can see by using the vectors W1 and W2, we can create a matrix by considering them as columns, as you can see here. 6, 1, minus 7, minus 1, 1, 0. We have 3 by 2 matrix. And we can understand that the given set written here is actually equal to the column space of the matrix A, which is 3 by 2, because every vector in this set is the linear combination of W1 and W2, which are the columns of this matrix. According to the definition written here, instead of A1 and A2, we have W1 and W2. So the set is equal to the column space of the matrix A. So we have an important theorem similar to the null space. The column space of an m by n matrix A is a subspace of R to the m, as I said, R to the m, r to the m, the number of components of all vectors is equal to the number of rows of the given matrix A, not columns. So this is known directly because we know a set spanned by some vectors is a subspace, and because of the definition of null space, column space, sorry, it is actually a set spanned by the columns of the matrix A, A1, A2, blah blah, An. Therefore, it is a subspace because we know a set spanned by some vectors is a subspace. So another example, we have 3x4 matrix here. You see the entries. If the column space of the matrix A is a subspace of R to the K, what is K? And if the null space of the matrix A is a subspace of R to the T, what is T? And find a non-zero vector in column space and a non-zero vector in null space. So you know, column space of n by n matrix, A is n by n, is a subspace of R to the m, and null space of a given matrix is a subspace of R to the n, the number of columns for the null space, the number of rows for the column space. So k is equal to 3 because we have 3 rows. M is equal to 3 and n is equal to 4. Therefore, the column space of the given matrix in this example is a subspace of R to the 3. We have 3 components for every vector in column space, okay? X has 3 components, x1, x2, x3, okay? And you can see easily by looking at the columns of the matrix A, we have 3 components for every column. Therefore, it is a subspace of R to the 3. If the null space of A is a subspace of R to the T, what is T? As you can see, this is the number of columns. The number of columns, namely T is equal to 4. According to the theorem star, because the general solution has 4 components. A general solution of this homogeneous system has 4 components. This is the subspace of R to the n. Therefore, n is equal to 4 and m is equal to 3. So find a non-zero vector in column space and non-zero vector in null space. What is column space? Column space of the matrix A is the linear combination of the columns. We have 4 columns here. C1, A1, plus C2, A2, plus C3, A3, plus C4, A4. A1, A2, A3, and A4. Okay. By writing any arbitrary numbers for the coefficients, which are C1, C2, C3, and C4, we can find easily a non-zero vector in column space. So you can choose any number. For example, if you choose simply 1 and the others are equal to 0, So we obtain a vector in column space, namely the first column actually, a2, minus 2, 3. This is a vector in column space. Okay. Easily, we find a vector in column space. We find a vector in column space. So to find a non-zero vector in null space, we have to find the general solution of the homogeneous system, as we talk about. We don't have any explicit expression for the vectors of the null space. Therefore, null space is defined implicitly, unlike the column space. We find easily an example for the column space, but for the null space, we need to do some operations to find an explicit, a clear expression for the vector in null space. Namely, we have to find a general statement for the solution of the homogeneous system to generate vectors, examples for the column space. So the augmented matrix will be in this form. This is the matrix A, and the last column is the right hand side of this homogeneous system. And after doing row operations, we find the echelon form, and we see we have three pivot positions which are located in the first column, second column, and fourth one, which means that x1, x2, and x4 are basic variables, x3 is free variable. Therefore, using the rows written here, for the first row we write x1 plus 9 x3, and x2 minus 5 x3 is equal to 0, and from the third row we write x4 is equal to 0. So we know x3 is free variable. X3 is free. The others are basic variable. We find the other basic variables in terms of the free variable. We know exactly x4, which is always 0. Therefore, for x4 we write 0. X1 is equal to minus 9 x3 from here, and x2 is equal to 5 x3. X3 is the free variable, therefore we write itself here, and writing x3 in front of the vector for each component, we obtain x3 times minus 9, 5, 1 and 0. Namely, all vectors in the null space is actually x3 times this vector, a multiple of this vector. Okay. As you can see, we have now an explicit expression, a clear expression for a vector in null space. Writing any arbitrary number for x3, we obtain an example for the null space. Simply, we take 1 for x3, and we obtain a non-zero vector in null space whose components are minus 9, 5, 1, and 0. Okay, this is an important example for the final. And another important example for the final. A is given in this form. Actually, I guess we have the same matrix, 2 minus 2, 3, 2 minus 2, 3, 4 minus 5, 7. Yes, we have the same matrix, A. And U and V are given here. U has 4 components and V has 3 components. And from the previous example, we know null space of the given matrix is a subspace of R to the 4, and column space is a subspace of R to the 3. So determine whether U is in null space. Could U be in column space? Let's check. u is in null space, namely we should check the condition of the null space, namely u should satisfy the homogeneous system. What is a times u? What is a times u? And u has four components, therefore u may be an element of the null space since we have four components. But we cannot say the same thing for v. Since we have three components, so we can say directly v is not an element of the null space. Okay, v is not an element of the null space. To say that u is an element of the null space of the matrix A, so it should satisfy the homogeneous system. So let's check the product of them written here. So we use the first row and the column, and we obtain the first number 6 minus 8 plus 2 plus 0, and you can do yourselves for the second and third component. So you obtain 0 minus 3 3. This is not equal to the zero vector, so u is not a solution of this homogeneous system. This is not equal to zero, therefore u is not in the null space. Okay, and v is not in the null space because v has three components, as I said here. V is not an element of the null space since we have three components. The second question, determine whether v is in column space of the matrix A. And can we say v is also an element of the null space? So since v is a subspace of R to the 3, so we can say or not v is in column space. We can see the situation, but we cannot see the same thing for u because u has four components, but all vectors in column space has three components. So to say that v is in column space, it should be a linear combination of the columns of the given matrix C1A1 plus C2A2 plus C3A3 plus C4A4. We should find weights such that it is the linear combination of the columns. So to understand that, we need to solve this equation actually by using the information that we know from the chapter 1. So we create augmented matrix, the corresponding augmented matrix A1, A2, A3, A4, and the vector V, and the columns are corresponding to weights C1, C2, C3, and C4, and this is the vector V. This is the augmented matrix for this vector equation. If we have a solution for this system, so we say that V is a linear combination of the columns of the matrix A, which means also that V is an element of the column space. After doing row operations, we see that we have pivot positions in the first two, second and fourth column. So C1, C2, and C4 are basic variable. C3 is free variable. Actually, we have infinitely many solutions. It is clear that the equation A times C is equal to V is consistent. We have at least one solution here. V is in column space. You can obtain a solution, for example, by using the last row. We write 17 times C4 is equal to 1. So C4 is equal to 1 over 70. From the second row, we write C2 minus 5 C3 minus 4 C4 is equal to 2 minus 2. Writing 1 over 17 for C4, and C3 is free variable. writing C2 in terms of the free variable. So we have a solution for C2, and also we can do the same thing for C1. So writing any real number, any arbitrary real number for C3, so we can find the values of C1 and C2, and we obtain a solution for this system. Therefore, we understand that V is a linear combination of the columns of the given matrix, so V is in column space. So V is not in null space because V has three components, but a vector in null space is has four components. Therefore, V is not in null space, and U is not in column space. U is not in column space since U has four components. Okay. Thank you very much for your listening. Please send your questions to me.